sure it's working. How's the stream looking? Sorry for the wait, what's with the I think that's everything. Okay. Oh shoot, well they were right at the door. They were right at the door. Can I go back to get the orb? Sinnoh the best. Yep, it is. every time I go down this route, I think this is a way down. No matter how many times I play this game, no matter how many times I go down this route, I get stuck right there thinking that's how to go down. Professor Oak, the Giratina Wedge. That was Lucas's idea. That wasn't mine. I don't get credit for that joke. I don't know if anyone else is gonna be joining in the stream, but it's me. Ah, oh, she's blocking it up. Dang it! I wanted to get the orb. Okay, you're just going to Sunny Shore then, I guess. Okay, so I guess... Guess I'm gonna have to go on without Origin Giratina, at least for now. I can't remember if it opens up after you beat the next gym or if it's after you beat the League. Stream looking okay? I hope it's not all bugging out. Oh, so that's gonna be the first catch for the route. Works sometimes. I think League. Oh, I think you think League. Watch, this one's gonna be Electabuzz. Like, yeah, I was like, that would have been way cooler to have, but of course, I don't get that. Shoot, I forgot to name the chat hot. Unless there's a delay. I don't think there is. Okay, the Selectabuzz gotta chill out. Ready to go back to heal Pulp Fiction. That is not. I thought I had the bike on the. Forgot I used that when I was getting, raining experience points. So I almost started streaming Legends Arceus on launch, but I remembered that I hadn't finished this yet, and I'm tired of our general dropping playthroughs freely, so I want to see this one through to the end before moving on to another Pokémon game. Also, my sister wants me to play Undertale because I have not finished it yet. Legends Arceus, by the way, I'm having a blast with that game. I'm so happy with it. Especially because most of the Pokemon streams leading up to this one were me dreading how Legends Arceus was gonna turn out. What does Mist do again? What's the goal for this playthrough? Beat the league. It's a Nuzlocke. There have been many, many casualties. I blame choosing Piplup. And then it like all snowballed into me losing so many team members. It's like when you don't have a lot of fire type coverage at the start, that's kind of a bad thing. Because Gardenia's when the gyms start getting a little tricky. At least the gym leaders. Just because she straight up has a Rose Raid. Right, I did not keep a Pokemon with Cut on me. Are you kidding me? See, that's why I'm not catching Electabuzz, because first Pokemon on the route was Chatot, so I had to catch that. A Nuzlocke on Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl would be a nightmare, because that game is actually, when people say it's harder than the originals, they're telling the truth. Like, all the like so many moves were swapped around. This trainer school with the Abra, they have Charter Beam, both of them. I almost got my first blackout in that game there. Actually, that was gonna be my only blackout in the game, if they had gotten away with the charge beam thing. I think next time, if the next time we do a Pokemon game, it's a Nuzlocke, might be random. I've said this so many times, I feel like I always have to repeat it, but, it might do a randomizer just because, it would make things a little more interesting. Yeah, the AI for Cynthia was really good, yeah. Yeah, that's the big praise I'll give, Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. It is, they did make the game harder. Though there's like a serious lack of polish in the game. Movement in that game is not very fun. Legends Arceus, though, I think the only issue I have with it is, it's not even that big of an issue because I don't really care that much, but the way they have like cell shading on it is kind of weird. Normally I really like cell shading, it just looks strange on Legends Arceus, I don't know why. Oh, wait, no, I also think the environments in Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl are really pretty. Really pretty. The water in Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl ranges from looking like a void in the middle of nowhere to, oh my gosh, this looks like real water. I did my best to recreate my original Platinum team in Brilliant Diamond. The only team member I couldn't add was Regigigas. The reason I had Regigigas on my original team was because of the Toys R Us event. Cell shading is nice, but it doesn't match the background. Yeah, that's the thing. It doesn't match the background all that much. But honestly, if that's, I said this online, but like, if this is the only drawback we get for a good Pokemon, for like a solid Pokemon entry, I'm fine with that. Let me teach this guy another move. I love the water. Yeah. But like, okay, so there's like weird pools of water. The Legends of Water looks pretty bad. I'd say what looks weird about the water and it's some of the water in Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl, like those small little like pockets of water that would be in like Eterna City or whatever, some of those don't really look like water and they just look like a void of nothing in the middle of the floor. If I could get a screenshot of it, I would. Actually, wait. Could I? I can find a good screenshot of it, maybe. Just for when this goes up on YouTube. The water in the lakes looks good in the in the different lakes and the ocean, it looks good. It's just where am I get where can I get a screenshot of it? The water, I cannot find this. It is a very pretty game. I do like, and I do like the tiny people. Like, it's I understand not a lot of people like it, but the I think Pokemon, I agree with Lucas on how Pokemon should have looked like that when it transitioned to 3D. Yeah, I can't get a good screenshot of it, so I'm just gonna continue. Like it just like to just explain it just kind of looks like there's just a hole in the floor and there's just like you know like in Minecraft you're creative mode and you break bedrock and there's just like empty blue down there. It looks like that. It looks like just someone took out a chunk of the land and then just the voids below it. I gotta teach Pinehead a new move. He can't keep using Wood Hammer and everything. Sorry, she. They only put like one original content thing in Brilliant Diamond outside of like the redoing the like one like fully original thing for the game and I can't even say what it is because it's a spoiler. But I will say its existence makes me wonder, because I've had people tell me that they think the game's gonna get platinum DLC, but the existence of this thing that I will not mention makes me think otherwise. I would love Legends Arceus DLC though. Maybe something like connecting the Johto region. Because of stuff like the Sinjo ruins from Heart Gold and Soul Silver. Heal continues to fall. Yeah, I'm not done with Legends Arceus yet. No, well, you know, No, I'm not done with Legends Arceus either. I'm talking about Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. There's one thing that's like completely original that they added that I don't want it to say because it would be a spoiler. But it's like it's very brief. And it's cool at first, but like it's also kind of a letdown that that's like the only thing that they original thing that they added. Thank you. Yeah, I'll try to avoid. Whenever I do a playthrough, I will try to avoid saying spoilers unless it's a game that's been out for like 20 years. Spoiler alert, the piano in Mario 64 is alive. Speaking of Mario 64, there's this thing that came out recently. I always forget, it's like B3133 or something like that. Now I'm curious. Do you want at least a hint of what it is? Cause like, you kind of need to take a certain amount of steps to get it. It's something that if you want to go out of your way to complete the National Pokédex on there, you're gonna end up running into it on accident. Actually, you know, I will say one thing that'll be as vague as possible. That gives you a hint on what to do, but not saying what it is. It involves Ranimas Park. The place where all the legendaries are, but it's not any Luigi's Re- Yeah, okay, so it's Ranimas Park where they replaced the Pal Park with. The place where you can get legendaries depending on like what copy of the game you have. But it's not any of the legendaries that you have. It's not any of the legendaries that they talked about that are in there. So like when they were talking about how you catch like Lugia, Ho-Oh, the dogs, and Zapdos, the birds, like that. It's not any of those. It's not catching a Pokemon. There's something there that you unlock eventually. But you need Giratina. You need Giratina. I will say that. I forgot I gave him a citrus berry. It's been that long since the last stream. I don't wanna have this many breaks in between streams. Friends were saying they're kind of burned out, so we're just kind of taking a break. Oh, but okay, so back to the Mario 64 thing. There's this ROM hack that came out that's like, it's like a whole, it's basically like a quote fake beta build of the game. And it like makes, it's like a whole maze. It makes the castle like a huge maze of some kind, and like there's way more stars than before. But it takes things from the actual beta of Mario 64 and stuff that's just to make it mysterious. And it looks really interesting. I can't remember what. It's like B33133, something like that. Okay, hold on, I gotta go back to heal. I don't know how to explain the ROM hack without so like I've never played this game this that people compare the ROM hack to something called Yuminiki. I've heard of it, but I've never played it. The only reason I probably have not played many PC games is because when I was younger we had a Mac that could not run many games. It was not as game friendly as they are now. Wow, that barely did a dent. But like the whole hack has like the Mel Blanc voice lines from the beta of Mario 64. Some of the Giga Leak maps that people found, they're imported into the game. Oh, hold on. A good example of how to describe how the hack goes down is that the hub world, the main room, the entrance room of Peach's Castle has like three different versions of it that you can enter. And it'll like change. And they're subtly different too, it's funny. But it's just like, it's so. Finally! Finally he learns Tri Attack! Okay, should I get rid of Psybeam or Signal Beam? Okay, so Signal Beam can take care of grass types and dark types. But Psybeam takes care of fighting types, and fighting types are gonna be Digidex problem. So I think I'm gonna get rid of Signal Beam. I'd rather Heat Stab. Let's take it for a spin. Yes, nice. Well, this will do me a lot of help. Ooh. I would like to play the ROM hack on stream, but I watched like way too much gameplay of it, and I think that would kind of kill the surprise that comes with it. Cause like it's very much something you want to watch someone play, like someone like experience for the first time. That's more like it. All right, one more dude before the next gym. Sailor Luther, Lex Luther. Lex Luthor, Batman v Superman. Oh my gosh. Machoke. Oh no, I should not have Machoke out. Weird seeing a Pokemon and a Master Ball, because I like never use them anymore. I feel like it's bigger of a feat to catch a legendary without it. I think the last time I used a Master Ball on a legendary was when I played Black 2 for the first time. Also because I found out that ever since Sun and Moon, they started giving the box art legendaries really high catch rates. So it's like, why use it on a Master Ball then? That's why my Solgaleo is in a Moon Ball. And my Zacian is in a Dream Ball. Okay, oh, see ya. Thanks for joining in. Oof. Pinehead is going to like take herself down with Cynthia's Gastrodon. It keeps doing that. But yeah, so my Solgaleo is in a Moon Ball. My first Necrozma is in a fast ball. Zacian's in a Dream Ball. And my Eternatus is also in a Moon Ball. There's been so few good challenges with this time. He's been so bored, he spent all the time renovating the gym. That can help him. He's trying to help lift his mood. We're going this, don't you? You rebel. Having compassion for battling. I'm counting on you, big shot. Thank you. counting on you, Big Shot. I love the Sunny Shore City music. So these guys gotta get to level 50 if we want to take down Electivire, Faulkner, Electivire, Faulkner. I would love to see a city like that. That's all those solar panels. Like futuristic aesthetic that Pokémon would have in the early 2000s. Oh, there's a bug on my screen. You'll be forced to turn back. Forced to turn back, cave. The bug is back. Be gone. Oh wait, seriously? I didn't know that. I didn't know they were related. I guess when you don't go to this area often, you don't really remember that piece of info. Guess we gotta go back down to the route and do training. Ooh, Ice Punch. That's good. That's a good one. Ice Punch. Put ice in the punch. Actually, hold on, let's see what Professor Oak can learn. Shoot, I'm out of heart skills! Oh man. Man, Drain Punch used to have 5 power points. It's been so long. It's always funny to remember that. Some of these moves were considered overpowered back then. That they warranted to only get 5 uses. Maybe I should give a shell ball to them so they can like make some, and then give him something like he doesn't need an accuracy boost. Actually, you know, let's see. Hold on, what? I gotta remember what items I can get at the Veilstone Game Corner. Also, rip that in Brilliant Diamond and Shining Pearl. Items I can give Bort. Double team. Oh shoot. Sword stand. Ooh, wait, sword stands. I already have these. Shoot. Actually, what else is there? Rest. U-turn. Hidden power. Return. It's frustration. Flamethrower. Thunderbolt. Ooh, Thunderbolt would be good. Ice Beam. Psychic would be good too. Gyro Ball. KK Impact. You know what, sure, let's hang out on here a little bit. Why does this have to get taken out of a Pokemon game for being considered gambling, but we're stuck with freaking loot boxes in games? Double standards. Yeah, open up. Aw. And ball now. Now. See, I called it. Ball now. Hey! Poor me, little me didn't know you could hold the button down to speed that up back then. Those 5 seconds I could have saved. Shoot, I messed up. My finger slipped. Okay, now I gotta mess up on purpose. I'm actually trying to get a shiny, Cleffa right now. I really like the shiny. It's because of this game. Oh, I'm leaving so soon. Another blue. Okay, ball now. My finger slipped again. Oh! Hey! It doesn't take that long. Crazy how Safari Ball is considered really rare now. Like, there's a 0.1% chance of getting it in Sword and Shield. I guess that won't last long though, now that, now that you can get them in Brilliant Diamond, Shining Pearl. Now, Sport Ball, that's another. Finger keeps slipping. Did I get the bug? I hope I did. Ding, 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 ding Yeah. Encore. Okay, I gotta think of a game plan for when I get to the Pokemon League. Maybe I should just make all of my Pokemon forget HMs. And then save the... Like, give one random Pokemon I have in the PC fly. And then just, like, right before I fight the League, like, delete all of their HMs and then just give them better moves. Snore is probably gonna benefit the most from not having to use HMs. And Lucario. Bort and Pulp Fiction, I mean. But you can't get rare candies with this. Sick of this little bug that's like flying around. Where'd it come from? Yes. Oh my gosh, it keeps coming back! There. Taken care of. Where is everyone? What they're all up to. Thank you. I have never been to a casino. I don't know why I would go to one. I've just never been to one. But see, it's only fun when you have, like, fake tokens you can use. Like this. And there's a Clefairy in it. That's the only way I'll play a slot game. If there's no Clefairy in a slot game, that's unplayable. Like, you've already failed. You've already failed designing a game. Oh my gosh, over 1,000 coins. I really miss playing this. Am I like the only person who doesn't like Voltorb Flip? Like every time like I have a discussion with someone about the game corners in Pokémon, like everyone's like, oh yeah, Voltorb Flip was a good alternative. Like, but I hate Voltorb Flip. I could never figure out how to play it. That game felt more like gambling than the slot machines in the other game corners. This card could easily be a Voltorb, and it probably is. I've only ever gotten to round 2 in that game ever. Actually, no, I think I got 3 one time. Getting a Porygon was pain in our Gold and Soul Silver. For that reason. Did I just do that when the moon was red? Shoot. Okay, I think I cancel it out. The moon was white. What would you guys want to see first? Undertale or Legends Arceus? Undertale or Legends Arceus? Because I did promise I was going to play Undertale. My sister's like, I can't talk to you about these Deltarune theories because you haven't finished Undertale. Besides, I want to be able to listen to the music, and I've actually avoided so much of the music of that game for so long. I've avoided spoilers of that game for so long. I am baffled that, like, nothing has been spoiled for me in that game other than Megalovania and why that's there. Like, is that just pure luck, or are people actually that respectful about Undertale spoilers? Yeah, so, Steam Labs OBS was, like, under, like, a bunch of criticism recently. And I signed Arcadescapades up for that once, and then I immediately took it back, because, like, just something didn't feel right about that website. And it turns out I was right, that gut feeling was right. Like, they are not actually associated with OBS, they just have the name. It's funny that their abbreviation is SLOBS. Shoot. Finger slipped again. It's weird how this very real DS buttons I'm having a problem with them because that it did the thing. Okay, when Clefairy actually leaves, I'll go back to, like, training Pokémon. It won't be this the whole time. I said when Clefairy leaves! Wait, hold on, what's this? Someone sent me a thing. Sent me a thing. My friend just mentioned Hisui and Lin. I don't know if he's serious or not. I can't tell if he's joking. Garfield, are you slash Sirs or slash Jay? You know, I expect a long chain like this from a shiny Clefairy. I pressed the wrong button again! I I pressed the wrong button. Why do I keep doing that? I think I'm like anticipating what the next one's already gonna be before I even see it, and then I just hit the button way too early. You get into like a rhythm with this game. Oh, wow. Okay. Training Pokemon, we go. I'm gonna need hard skills if I'm gonna relearn Pokemon a bunch of moves for the end. Did I ever get a lucky? Yeah, I did get a lucky egg. Okay. Aw, Magnemite! That would have been so cool! Glad that was a critical hit. I was not in the mood to use another move for that. Train on Steel Wing. Okay, well, he's gonna have a problem with Steel type, so maybe he gets like a Fighting type move or a Fire move. He gets Aura Sphere, but I don't want to use Aura Sphere. He's a physical fighter. Actually, wait. What's his stats gonna look like? His special attack is slightly higher. Raised by 3 points. Hilarious. I teach him to fight off? Oh, maybe I can teach him Earthquake. Do I have Earthquake? They have Dig. I do not have Earthquake. How do I get Earthquake? I can't remember. You're really a secret, huh? Skill swap, Roost, Brine, Fling, Drain Punch, Silver Wind, Embargo, Shadow Claw, Payback, Stealth Rock, Psychic Rock Slide. Dang it, no one can learn U-turn. Dang it. Oh, shoot. Ancient power.
Hello.
Oh, hey, hey, I heard music for a second. I was like, whoa, where's that coming from?
I actually just realized my parents watching Amazing Race in the room, so I can't be in here because of DMCA. Sorry.
Can you believe DMCAs are that out of control? They have to get worried about background noise. Oh, just barely. Thomas the Tank Engine? Policeman Thomas the Tank Engine? Police Tank Man the Thomas? Right, buddy, we get it, you're fast. Okay, so Floatzel's the XP Windows XP. Floatzel's the Windows XP. Ooh, nice. Nice Connor cameo. Not you. Wait, is one of the move tutors here? Maybe they can teach Seed Bomb to Pinehead, so it's not as risky. Size contest. Pikachu fan club. Shoot. Pikachu fan club. Making good progress. Oh, come on. Oh, that's lame. So it is, you don't get Origin Giratina until you beat the Elite Four. Oh, you try to whirlpool? 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 Oh my gosh, everything's happening so fast. Outspeeding the floatzels now. Didn't feel on a quick loot. Oh, come on! Heal block. Oh, shoot. Oh, Pelipper. Aw, man. The floats will grind set. Hey, who said you could use Crunch? Oh man, on that note, that's really sad. They had to take down the old peanut SCP picture from the website. 173. Okay, I was holding my breath for a minute there. Things weren't looking good. Although, even though they have to take it down, it's going to be really hard to separate that image from the SCP itself. It's kind of like when Facebook tried to rebrand itself, and like everyone just kept calling it Facebook still. It's like that. Like, no one's going to call it Meta. Everyone's going to keep calling it Facebook. Oh, actually, you know what? Do I have any of... I do. I'm gonna try to get him to level 52. So they're at least two levels above of Vulpner's Pokemon. Oh, dang. Why'd I do that? I meant to... Man. Okay, cool, so we can take down Electabuzz in one hit now. You again. Magnemite is quickly becoming a sea bass. Okay. Oh, right, I taught him. Actually, wait, no, I can't remember if I. Going by smoothly. Actually, hold on, I wonder how much. Oh, come on. Man. Oh, nice. See, that water absorb can come in handy during the Elite Four. Can do a good swap out. Fine. Living life in the fast lane. Oh gosh, no. Never mind. That somehow feels slower than just using the bike. Nah, it's not worth it. No. He said no. I thought he was strong enough to be KOing them now. Well, just one more level. I really like to catch that. Just one hit KO, please. Just get on with it. I need two floatzels to level up with the amount of power points I have left. There's one. Oh, I guess it can be anything. Except for Magnemite. Not a Magnemite. Training him is gonna be so hard. Cause I'm gonna have to keep leaving to having to heal him. See, I already gotta go take and get healed. Hey. Hey. Oh my gosh, this playthrough is... Oh my gosh. Thank you. At least I have a bunch of money in the game. I can use it on healing items. And see how he likes it. Use wood hammer, I'm not gonna use it. Scared. Good that did you, huh? You know, when the lowering the stat lower animation plays in fast, quickly, it kind of looks like it's going up, not down. Swapping him out because he's healing. Oh, forget it. Fine. Is it just gonna be a game of swapping them out? Delta moved to the Delta. Did I say you could? No ads. No. Bad. See, you can't spell ad without bad. No, wait. I said that wrong. Shoot. Can I play that's not gonna get me a copyright claim? Or even a fake one. Tired of the fake ones. I don't think I can play anything. Man, YouTube sure is fun when you literally can't play anything, or else some company pretending to be another company will copyright strike everything. Isn't that fun? Especially if you're a channel called Kiva Sunner and you get a bunch of fake claims so much that you're contemplating taking down the channel. I left Bort out. I didn't mean to hit run. Okay, and he's gonna have to keep going until like 52. You know what, I think now is a good cutoff point. Just cause, actually, you know what? No, you know what? We get Pulp Fiction to level 50. Or not 50, 52. Nah, you know what? Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Let's just keep on going. I think maybe in 30 minutes that's the cutoff point. Thank you. Discharge. Discharge or dat charge? Which one? Come on. It's taking so long. It's been so long. And the largest teacher's hunt. You know, I'm lucky there's a healing spot this close. I can't pull out of healing items after this. What the heck? That's cheating. That's not good. Get you KO. Okay, that was... That could have gone terribly wrong if they used it. Mm. No. Oh my gosh, another one? That would have been nice to have that. Actually, I already got a steel type. Legends Arceus, it's actually good. No, not Blizzard. Give up on Blizzard. Give up on Blizzard. I know I have. Connor's gonna kill me for saying that. footnote, he's not a fan of how Blizzard was being handled either at the moment. He just misses when they made good stuff. Whoa. Almost dropped the cup. Why is this gonna take so long? Did you duck? Did you paralyze? Yeah. You know, I should just stop saying that because then I jinx it. Get at least to level 50. Two more levels to go. Okay, I'm making a stop to get items. Just get it to level 50, that's the end goal. It's end goal. Wait, actually, hold on. That's not what I meant to do. Hey, ever noticed how the abbreviation for Pokemon Legends Arceus is PLA? It starts with it's like platinum. I don't think it's a coincidence. What are they hiding? What are they hiding? How quiet can I make this? This is as quiet as possible. All I have to do is just keep talking over it so it doesn't get a copyright claim. What's up with that part of the song that sounds like a bunch of tennis rackets hitting a ball? Come on, go. gotta keep talking over the song. Wasn't that like a spin-off thing for Sesame Street? Like 1, 2, 3 Sesame? Or was it like Play With Me Sesame? Something like that. I remember that. I remember that being a thing. Hold on, I gotta see this really quick. Wait, I forget this guy. Okay, level 49, we're almost done! Hold on. Let's see. Play with me, sis. Yeah, yeah. Play with me. Load. Play with me, sis, he's an American child. He's an American child. Oh, it was a spin-off on Noggin. That was, Nickelodeon Sesame developed the show to expand on the Sesame Street by directly encouraging younger viewers to interact with the characters. To the same combined classic Sesame Street footage with new segments where hosts invite preschoolers to join them in games. Play With Me said the last episode aired on September 2nd. 2007. At its launch, it was announced that Play With Me Sesame would continue to be produced for Noggin through 2009, but the show instead wrapped up in 2007. Oh my gosh, remember? Where is he? Hold on. Do you remember this dude? I know that's a gif, never mind. Where is he? Where, hold on, come on, look, come on. Oh, that doesn't even say the moose guy. Moose a moose. Noggin. No, that's not what I meant. This dude. The moose dude. No. Is he still a thing? Is he like still on like Junior or whatever? Or the what was that? That star thing from Sprout that was on like PBS Kids. I don't remember the star's name. I just remember it like really funny. It was like a puppet. Now I gotta know this. Yeah. This dude. Oh my gosh. I like to see this dude in motion. Aw, man. Oh, wait, hold on. Maybe I can hit, Star. Star name. Me trying to remember Star's name. I want to see this dude, like, being, like, weird. That's... That looks cursed. Oh my gosh. What other, like, weird, kids show hosts were there? Is this still going? I need to know this. Yep. Dude. This ended the same day Club Penguin shut down. What the heck? Wait, hold on. He was sure I remember me dying too. Did they drop the humans from the male humanoid? Dude! He was the bear? For Bear in the Big Blue House? Oh good, he's still around. Aw, you know what I miss? I miss the, programming. They stopped playing Dragon Tales? Oh my gosh, the rubber duck. Moved in 2011. We did get to know the Wiggler is still there. Berenstain Bear is still there. They've stopped Kipper. Oh my gosh, I miss these so much. The one with the strange looking one with Adam at. That was one of my favorites. Same thing for the, same thing with the Jabberjaw one was catchy. Why did you do this to yourself, Boomerang? What is this? Why'd they put that Scooby-Doo there? Come on, play. Hit a gift. Hit a gift. Hit a gift. Yeah! I think I should get back to the game. Oh wait, there we go. Got caught up in like 10 minutes of looking at old cartoon mascots. Yes, Windmill Isle has been playing for that long too. Why do you keep getting paralyzed? Hurry up! if you want to talk like the best cartoon host, the old like kids show host, it's gotta be Steve from Blue's Clues. He's the best one. There's like no contest on that. I love the Blue's Clues lore of the different hosts being related. So like currently in the Blue's Clues like universe, Steve graduated college and now he's a detective. I don't remember what they said Joe was up to. I know that they said Steve was a detective now. And he apparently he cameos sometimes. Well, both of them do, I'm pretty sure. Three 3D Blue is kinda strange, but you know what? It's still got a heart. Yeah, so what, I've seen a few episodes. I got a little Blue's plush that like has magnets in the paws and it like you can like make them pull together. My earliest memories of that was sticking that to a TV screen. I don't remember it breaking. Thankfully. I'd have to ride that guilt for the rest of my life if I broke the TV doing that. Come on, I'm almost done. So close. Come on. What the hell, he'll take you out. Just to be mean. Slow and painful for Electabuzz. I can't even be a Floatzel. No, not you. You know, I'll even take this. It doesn't matter, because now he's level 50.